Do you need a word store? You know what a word store is? Okay, so I'm going to give you a list of words, and we're going to categorize them into three different categories based on their vowel sounds, okay? So we have the R control category, the long U category, and the short U category. So before we start categorizing, I want us to go through and read the words so that we make sure we know what they are, okay? Can you read that for me?
First day.
Good job.
Okay. Spruce.
Do you know what a spruce is?
No.
It's like a tree. So for Christmas, do you guys get a real tree? Or do you have a fake one?
We have a white one.
Oh, cool. So the tree that you get for Christmas, the Christmas tree, is called a spruce tree.
June.
You know what a burrow is?
I've heard it before, but that's not how I've seen it spelled.
Right, so the burrow you're probably thinking about is like a burrow underground. This is like, it's like a small donkey that other states use to help carry around their luggage.
Chess. Flute.
Do you know what a rule is? It's like, it's a word that describes the countryside. So if you're driving down the road through the country and you see a bunch of farmland and houses, that would be considered the rural countryside.
Brush.
You know what a prune is?
Mm-hmm. It's like there's wet bushes.
Kind of, this is a different kind of prune. This prune is it's a dried out plum. So like how raisins are dried grapes, a prune would be a dried plum.
Lush. Curly. Dude. Surgeon.
Good job. So now I'm going to model some words for us. So I'm going to pick three words that go one in each of these categories so we have an example. Bursting. So since we're looking at the U vowel, I'm going to listen for what the U vowel says. Bursting. I can't really hear the U. So there's an R right next to it, and the R kind of takes over and doesn't let the U say anything. Bursting. So I'm going to put this right here under R control because the R is taking plum. Plum. Good job. The U is short. Spruce. Goose. The U is kind of stretched out and long. So we'll put this right here under down here. Okay, now let's do some together. So I'm going to hand you the stack, and I want you to pick up one, read it out loud, and try to figure out where to place it on the categories. So what do we hear the U saying? See, like plum, it says plum, some drum. Can you do another one for me? Good job. Okay, one more. Can you do that right now? How'd you know to put it there? You looked at the pattern. Good job. Okay, so I'm going to let you do the rest by yourself, and I'll just watch, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Do you need some help? What's your word?
Prune.
Prune. Okay, when I say prune, what do you have a U sound saying? Prune. It's kind of stretched out and long. Prune. So why don't we put it with a long U? So, how did you put these words in the short category? So I'm going to give you a new set of words, and we're both going to categorize them, and you're going to try to do it faster than I am. But I want you to remember to look at the words and sound out the letters and really listen for the U sound, okay?
Understanding there's an issue with power taker. If you're having trouble with that. Just make sure I get your attendance in the office on a sticky note or some sort of paper. Thank you.
All right, and you didn't get any of them wrong. I mean, you did, you corrected it. Good job, I'm very proud of you. So the purpose of doing this with you today was to help you recognize the different vowel sounds in words. So when you're reading or spelling, you know how to distinguish between the three vowel sounds that we did today. Okay? Yeah. Took a long time to cut them out. So can you tell me something that you learned from doing this with me? I can close it for you. Good job. Thank you for your help today. You did good.